I have a couple artists that I wanted to talk about that were like early pioneers. And I was texting you this week
about it. I saw a few on there that I recognized and I thought, wow, that's a good example.
Yeah, like the real early, like early, like 40s and 50s. So the first one was Big Mama Thornton. And I want to, it's important to talk about, like, women have been involved in the history of rock and roll from the very beginning. And Big Mama Thornton actually wrote the song Hound Dog, and Elvis's version was a cover.
Yes.
And it's awesome. So yeah. here's a little bit of that.
You ain't.
Man, what a dude.
Oh, man, she's soulful. It.
Man, some and of the
she's
guys
playing guitar on that. She's ripping it.
And some of the guys playing backup for her include Muddy Waters, Buddy Guy.
Wow.
I mean, just, fucking awesome. And she was like, she was 6 feet tall. She weighed 2 bills. She had a big a gap between her two front teeth. Yeah. Just awesome. Awesome rock and roll, man. And the other one I wanted to talk about was Sister Rosetta Tharpe. And she was a guitar player that came up in like the 30s and 40s. But she played the guitar, and she was one of the first people to put like distortion on everything. And like guys like the real early rock and rollers, like Jerry Lee Lewis and Johnny Cash and all these guys, said like they looked at her like she was an influence. And so here's a little bit of what a song did I hear? Don't take everybody to be your friend. This is really cool. Yeah, here you go. And she was like kind of a gospel bluesy singer because there's no rock and roll when this
well, that's
came
where
out,
it all man. Came from anyway.
Absolutely. Here you go.
Yeah, man.
Don't take everybody to be your friend. You just found this in mind. Not a true friend is hard to find. Please don't take everybody for your friend.
That's her playing the guitar.
Dude, you know what she is, right?
She's a motherfucker.
Oh, yeah. She's a motherfucker, man. You hear that.
She went on tour with Muddy Waters in the 60s. And Clapton, Jeff Beck, and Keith Richards of all said that that was a holy shit moment for them, seeing her play guitar. Man. And it's like, I don't think a lot of people have no idea who she is.
I never heard of her. People, she's lost in history, man.
Right.
They got to put people like her in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Yeah, I don't know if she's in the... She is. She was put in 2018 as one of those early influencers.
Okay.
But I was like, shit, dude, like a woman... who was born in 1915, shredding it. And so she was one of the first people to play the electric guitar. She was one of the first people to use like distortion on her guitar. And she's an African-American woman again, and just largely forgotten.
She had a sound, man. The
Absolutely,
sound.
Absolutely, man. Yeah. Said it was like you said, it was like rock and roll didn't even exist yet.
No, but she was playing guitar like she was rock and roll.
Yeah. That was really cool. That was one of those when I uncovered that doing all this research. I'm like, holy shit. I love that doing the show. Like you find something that you've never heard before.
Hey, man, she played guitar just like Chuck Berry would.